DMD, or Duchenne Muscular Dystrophy, is the most common muscle disease affecting young boys. It affects about 1 in 3,600. It's an incurable condition, and it results in really muscle weakness that worsens over a boy's lifetime. Typically, boys lose their ability to walk around age 12. As boys go through adolescence, they have usually additional complications related to their lung or pulmonary health, as well as, more often than not, will develop cardiac disease, heart disease, and unfortunately most boys will pass away in their 20s from complications such as pneumonia or heart failure.
In order to combat diseases like this, we have to study the structure of proteins that are associated with that particular disease. In order to do that, we first must crystallize the protein. And that crystal is basically millions of copies of that same protein aligned like a row of bricks on a wall, but in three dimensions. But here's the problem. When we try to grow a crystal on Earth, gravity can affect the way the molecules become aligned on the crystal surface, and that affects the overall quality of the crystal. The ideal environment to grow a more perfect crystal would be a lab that we could have up in space orbiting the globe so that we are free of Earth's gravity. Luckily, we have one of those with the International Space Station.
Since 2003, the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency has conducted more than 16 sessions of the protein crystal growth experiments on board the International Space Station.
In microgravity, the crystals grow much more slowly, but the molecules have more time to get perfectly arranged on the surface of the crystal, and that gives us much better data.
One of the most promising results has been gained by studying a protein associated with Duchenne muscular dystrophy.
Studying this protein led to a huge discovery. Like a key fitting into a keyhole, we are able to design the drug that perfectly bind to this protein.
By knowing the shape of that keyhole, we can tailor make a drug to fit into a specific location of the protein.
What this means is we may be able to slow the disease by half. Instead of being in a wheelchair at 12, we might be able to push that age to 25. Instead of being dependent upon this patient at 20 years old, it would be 40. What we're talking about is potentially doubling the lifespan of many of these DMD patients. And it's all because of research opportunity afforded to us by the International Space Station.
This research is really just in its infancy. There are literally thousands of other proteins whose structures we need to determine, and the International Space Station is going to provide a platform where we can hopefully grow much better crystals. It'll allow us to get structures and to learn more about how these molecules function in our body, in bacteria, or in viruses. We're doing this research not just for ourselves or our children, but for generations to come. Many of the protein structures that will be determined wouldn't be possible without the International Space Station.
I'm hoping that those trials will be successful, but they will tell us, yes, there is a way that we can keep these boys stronger for a longer period of time, that we can help their heart and pulmonary function, and that they can live longer, that they can grow up and go to school and do the things that we all want our children to do.